Welcome back. We have some breaking news for you in the Kellen Winslow Jr. case. The former NFL player will be retried for the 8 remaining charges that deadlocked a jury earlier this week. Tuesday, the jury said it could not reach unanimous decisions on 8 of the 12 counts against Winslow. That includes charges of rape and lewd conduct. Also today, the judge denying the defense's request for bail and home detention, saying Winslow is still considered a danger to the community. All right, take a listen. See if you remember this tune.
One more try. I didn't know how much I loved you. One more try. Let me put my arms around you. Living all these lonely nights without you. Oh, baby, can we give it one more try?
All right, we know you do. That takes us back to 1991. When that song, One More Try, by Timmy T, hit the number one on the charts. Now get this. Timmy T is back in the public eye, but not for another hit. He lives in Fresno, California, and he is fighting crime. AJ Cato from our affiliate, KGPE, has that story.
You steal that?
A suspected shoplifter gets more than he bargained for, rushing out of a River Park store Tuesday.
And as I was getting off my scooter, I noticed a man run out of Bed Bath & Beyond with a package under his left arm. And it was a big box, and the alarm was going off.
A man on a Segway following after him, camera recording the whole time, grabbing clear shots of his face.
Quite honestly, I see theft a couple times a week.
A number that's just too high for this Fresno native. People may know Timmy Torres better as Timmy T.
One more try.
Burning up the charts in 1991 with his number one hit, One More Try. Now, when he's not making music, he's on a different beat.
Is that guy still there?
Yeah!
Trying to curb criminal activity. His camera rolling whenever he is.
I don't even think about my safety. It's just an instinct, you know? I wish more people would get involved.
Torres made headlines before in 2016 for breaking up a fight between two women on Fruit Ave. He says he cannot just sit back and watch and believes others should not either.
I think it would happen less and less if more people were able to just speak out. You know, when they see something happen, don't be afraid to call the police, take down a license plate, you know, do what you have to do. Because, I mean, this is our community and we need to keep it safe.
Don't you wish there were more stories like this? Joining me now is Timmy T. Thank you so much for joining us, sir. I just have to ask you, you said in that piece that it was almost instinctual. You used the word instinct. So I'm curious, was the first time you got involved, if I'm not mistaken, it was when those two women were arguing, was it instinct that brought you to that moment? And when did you decide to start recording these incidents?
Well, I see such crazy things on the street every day, and I encourage people to go out and get a dash cam. I mean, they're so inexpensive nowadays. I have dash cams in my car, and of course, I put one on my scooter, so when I'm riding around town, it just catches things, and I just happen to be at the right place at the right time, I suppose.
But you're in the right place at the right time more often than not. You stopped the women who were in the argument, but also you stopped a crime at a Starbucks. Tell me what happened in that incident, and was that also caught on camera?
Yes, it was. A guy just walked in, he went up to the counter, and the tip jar that they usually keep on the counter for the employees, a guy just reached over the counter, grabbed the tip jar, and began to walk out, and I intervened. I got in front of him, and I prevented him from leaving, and as I was talking to him, and I was getting the tip jar back from him, even one of the customers got up from the table and started lecturing this man on stealing and telling him, basically, if you need money, you need food, we'd be more than happy to get it for you, but you know, don't steal the employees' tips. I've witnessed so much crime, you know, during the week. If I can like drive by a dollar store and someone would run out with a basket full of items and they toss the basket, and there's been times I actually took the basket into the employees. I've seen so much crime, and I'm fed up. You know, America should start, you know, doing something about this.
But, you know, so many people see things happen, unsavory things, illegal things, and they just don't want to get involved. They don't have the energy or the confidence to do so. Where is your inspiration to step up and say, you know, not when I'm around?
Well, you know, I've had my car broken into in my own home, I don't know, maybe a half a dozen times. I've had to replace windows. My son's computer was stolen out of my car like 2 days before Christmas. I mean, there's crime in every neighborhood. It doesn't matter. You know, the incident that happened at Bed Bath & Beyond is a pretty nice neighborhood where that even happened. And crime is just on the rise. And I believe that criminals think they can get away with it because I believe the bar is set so low for the price of a crime that you don't get arrested unless it's
over
like
a... But don't you ever feel scared?
No, no, not at all. No. I guess it's just instinct, you know? It's just instinct. I don't know how else to put it. I mean, I'm not encouraging people to go out and confront a criminal. Obviously, you're putting your life at stake. But definitely, you know, get a description of the person, get a license plate whenever possible. Don't be afraid to call the police. You don't have to call 911. You can call the non-emergency line and at least convey the information to the police department so they'll you know, patrol the neighborhood. Maybe they'll pick the guy up even hours later.
So you're encouraging not to interject, but perhaps get involved or take action, if you will. Okay, Timothy, I can't let you go without just asking us if can you just sing the chorus to One More Try? We've got some fans in the control room and at home that are like waiting for it. So not only are you an inspiration, but you're also quite popular. So I think you don't have a choice.
Okay. All right, here we go. One more try, I didn't know how much I loved you. Living all these lonely nights without you. Oh, baby, can we give it one more try? There you go.
Timmy T, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate you are an inspiration. And for our viewers at home, we're going to be right back.
Thank you.